Hey there, Nation. Welcome to the show where we help you to play miniatures wargaming on a budget. It is I, Commander Cheapskate, and we are back with another episode of Cheap Shots. On this episode, for episode number 29, we're going to show you how to cheaply and quickly paint up some Warcry Spire Tyrants. As you can see right here in this photo, you may notice there's a bunch of Iron Golem miniatures in this photo, and the reason why is because the two female fighters, which are in the very front of the photograph, those two fighters are actually from the Spire Tyrants box set for Warcry. I'm just painting them up in the colors of the Iron Golems because we're using them for our Pit Fighter Warband for our Necromunda campaign, not Necromunda, sorry, for our Morhaime campaign. That's what we're painting up those laser look like. So if they look like Iron Golems, that's the reason why, is because you paint them up to make them look like that. But regardless of how you paint up your guys' Spire Tyrants, any way that your method that you use, so long as you use the Cheapskate method that we're going to show you how to quickly and cheaply paint these things up, you can paint these guys very, very quickly and also have a beautiful tabletop standard at the same time, saving you over $118 in the process of doing that as well. So with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, let's go ahead and get this video on a roll and talk about exactly how you can paint up your Spire Tyrants Warband on the cheap and do it very quickly. Alright, so the very first two steps that you need to use are actually using spray paint on this one. So you can see we have our two female fighters. We have our Pit Fighter, I believe it's Pit Fighter Champions, what they're actually called for the Spire Tyrants. What we do, first of all, is you got to prime the miniature. Spraying gold on black, gray plastic is a really bad idea. So the very first thing I decided to use is using some Rust-Oleum Flat White Primer. It runs you about $3.99 at your local Walmart. Just gave it the once over real quick for both of those miniatures, just so we have a good primer base to kind of work off of. Priming is important because it adds a texture to the outside of your miniature for your paint to stick, on. At the same time, undercoating it white will also add some vibrancy to the colors that you add to the miniature later on. Now, like I said before, these guys have a lot of, they're actually chaos models, so there's a lot of scroll work along the edge and the perimeter of the armor. And if anyone's ever painted up anything related to chaos, they know that that scroll work can actually be a huge pain to paint. And the reason why is because not only is the scrollwork very intricate on the armor panels, but at the same time, they're also beveled on each side, so that way you have like these slight 45 degree angles built into them. So you have to paint those angles, and if you get any paint on the armor panel itself, it can really screw up your finish, so it's a huge pain. The easiest way I found in order to get around that is to spray your actual entire miniature the color that you want your scrollwork to be. In this case, since we're painting these guys up to look like Iron Golems, the scrollwork design color we want to use is gold. So because of that, I use some Krylon flat gold spray paint and just give them a really quick light once over the entire miniature, so that way it gets into the scroll work. It saves us a lot of time in the long run, at the same time has a really good finish for the miniature as well. So that's steps one and two: do a base coat of white primer and then followed by a flat coat of gold spray paint. Now for steps three and step four, I did make a mistake on this one. I forgot to take a photo of step number three, but what you need to do now is base coat all the flesh with taupe gray by Anita's Craft Paint. The reason why is because it has like this nice grayish flesh kind of pale color going on with that stuff. So I like using that a lot. It's a beautiful color to use, especially if you want to paint these guys look like Iron Golems, or if you want to have them have a very gaunt features for their skin tone. So because of that, I just do two thin coats of taupe gray by Anita's paint in order to paint up the flesh. As you can see, I've done that to all the exposed flesh that's on these miniatures. And I will warn you, there is quite a bit of exposed flesh because these fighters are like gladiators, so you know they're meant to bleed, so like their limbs and stuff like that, they have a really exposed, there's not much armor on these guys, so paint up the flesh that you want with that taupe color. Then after you get done with that, of course, step number four is another base coat, and this time it's for all the leather bits. We're going to paint that in Pavement by Apple Barrel Paint. It's a 2 fluid ounce tube that runs you 50 cents at your local Walmart. Anita's gray taupe will run you about 65 cents at Hobby Lobby. And all you gotta do is put two thin coats of Pavement on all the parts that are leather. So all the belts, the buckles, the boots that they're wearing as well. If you notice the figure on the left hand side, she's actually wearing sandals, but the problem is that the straps for those sandals are really fine and minute, and it was kind of annoying to try to paint it. So I decided to look like she's wearing black slippers instead, is what I decided to do, because it's just easier and faster. And so that's exactly what I did. And the fighter on the right hand side, of course, is wearing boots. So you just paint those with two thin layers of Pavement. Pavement's actually a very, very dark gray. It's not all the way black, so it makes it, and it also has a little bit of a texture to it, makes it perfect for dry brushing. So just paint your two layers for your skin as well as for your leather, and you're ready to move on. All right, so after that, we go to step number five, which is a dry brush. In this case, do a light dry brush with granite gray is what we do. And granite gray is good for two reasons. One, it's good for the flesh. We put that color all over the exposed flesh, adds some three-dimensionality to the miniature because the light granite gray will cast the raised surfaces on the flesh, so that part's kind of nice. And at the same time, you can also dry brush all the leather bits with granite gray as well, because a nice little dry tone catches like the crinkles and the wrinkles within the leather, so it adds all like three-dimensionality to the miniature as well. So if you get some of this onto your skin, it's not a big deal because you're already dry brushing your skin with granite gray anyways. Adds a nice three-dimensionality to it, also does a really good job picking out those highlights. And once you're done with that dry brush, you're ready to move on. So the next thing we're going to focus next on is on the base coat for the hair. So these two miniatures actually have quite a bit of hair exposed on these guys. It looks like they have kind of like this mohawk looking look on the front on the left hand side. At the same time, the female front on the right hand side has her hair exposed as well. So I use Ripe Tomato by Apple Barrel Paint to do the front on the left hand side to give her like this orangish reddish kind of color. At the same time, for the front on the right hand side, I use Honey Brown by Americana Craft Paint. It's an acrylic craft paint that you can buy at your local Hobby Lobby that runs you 65 cents per tube of that stuff. And it's nice, kind of like blondish brownish color or dirty blonde color, so that's the kind of color I decided to go with that character. And just do two thin coats of both paints onto the hair, so that way, you know, kind of has a good finish on that part. And once you're done with the hair, you're ready to move on. So with step number seven, we start working on the finer details now. We start focusing on the fabric as well as the wrapping and cording around the grips of the weapons, as well as on the cording and wrappings along the characters. So in this case, I used Tahitian Blue by Delta Sarin Coat. Runs you about 65 cents at your local Hobby Lobby. And as you can see, I just kind of picked out certain aspects. So like their loincloths, for example, I picked that out in Tahitian Blue. The wrappings around their grips of their weapons, as well as their forearms, I've also included that as well. And that's a nice like little bright color that kind of contrasts nicely with the gold, as well as the red that we're planning on putting on these guys as well, to add a little bit more detail to it. And like I said before, I'm painting these Spire Tyrants to kind of match the Iron Golems that I painted up earlier to use in our Morhaime campaign. So that's the same color scheme I went with those guys. So I'm doing exactly the same thing with these characters as well. So I recommend putting two thin coats of the Tahitian Blue, so that way the gold underspray doesn't show through. And then once you're done with that, you're ready to move on to the armor. All right, so that takes us to step number eight, which is another base coat this time. And this time we're focusing on the armor panels of the characters. And we're using Anita's True Red by Anita's Acrylic Paints. Runs at 65 cents at your local Hobby Lobby. And for this one, you're only going to use one thin layer of the red paint. And the reason why that is the case is because when you have a gold underspray for the armor and you put the red paint on top of it, if you only put a single layer of the red, the gold kind of shows through the red paint that you put on the armor panels. This does, it gives it a kind of reddish metallic look, kind of like this red alloyed finish to the metal, and it looks really, really awesome as well. And so it makes your armor look like it's metallic red, which makes it really, really cool because that gold coat beneath it shines through a little bit. So just use a single layer of the True Red if you can. Try to make the coat as thin as possible, but you know, don't, you know, break a sweat on it, but just try your best. Now, like I said before, the scroll work, however, is very intricate on these armors. So you'll need to take a fine-tipped paintbrush and then slip the red paint in between the different scroll work. So for example, on the far on the right-hand side, she's got this chest plate that she has on. So you got to get into the intricate parts of it, of the four quadrants of it. Make sure you don't get into the gold scroll work. Same thing with the shoulder pad, the pauldron on the fighter on the left-hand side. Exactly the same thing for her as well. Also painted up the armor pieces on the elbows as well as knees for the fighter on the right-hand side, as well as our arm greaves of this color, as well as the punch dagger hilt on the fighter on the left-hand side as well. So take your time with it. Just put one single coat so that way the metallic kind of shows through. That way you have like this red alloyed finish on the armor. And the very last base coat that you need on these miniatures is all the parts that are going to be silver. And once you're done with the silver pieces, you're pretty much done. So for step number nine, all I did is I just picked out all the parts of the metallic that are going to be silver. And I did a simple single coat of metallic Gunmetal Gray by Folk Art. It's a 2 ounce fluid tube, runs you about 75 cents at your local Hobby Lobby. And all I did is just picked out all the parts that are silver. So things like the chainmail that's on the loincloths, the blades of their weapons, the hafts that's on the mace on the left-hand side, as well as the grip, the haft on the axe on the front on the right hand side as well. Also, any iconography that's located on the chest rigs or anything like that, I picked that out in silver as well. And you just need to do that the once over. And whether you're wearing it or not, you're actually pretty much done with these miniatures. In fact, you could actually take them from this right now. Once you do your base work, you could actually start filling them on the battlefield. However, like I said before though, this is a quick paint method. So what we're gonna do now is an oil wash is what we're gonna do next. We're gonna tie all these colors together at the same time, bring out a lot of detail in these miniatures. All right, so that takes us to step number 10, and step number 10 is an oil wash. So most people, when they do a quick paint method, they like to use Army Painter Strong Tone or Army Painter Soft Tone or Army Painter Dark Tone or whatever the colors are called. They like to use that in order to do an oil wash. The oil wash does a couple things. First of all, it actually seeps into all the recesses of the miniature, brings out a lot of detail. As you can see, these guys are very detailed now. At the same time, it also flattens the bright colors that you use and kind of blends the dry brushing as well. There's a nice little overall finish for the entire miniature. The only problem with using Army Painter is that Army Painter runs $32 a can, while Minwax Poly Shades and the Mission Oak color does exactly the same thing and only costs you $7. So because of that, that's what I use instead. It's a mixture of stain and polyurethane, so you add that to the miniature as well. It brings in all the details together, seeps into all the recesses, and blends all the colors together. It also mutes the bright colors that you're using earlier and just kind of ties it all together as well. Now, it is a mixture of polyurethane with the stain, so you do have to let this stuff dry. My suggestion to you for the next step is when you cure it, to cure it for 24 hours. So like I said, you let it cure for step number 11, and it's just the waiting game. You're just waiting 24 hours for the stuff to fully dry as well as cure, because there is polyurethane mixture in with it, with the stain as well. And as you can see, this is the end result, which your miniature will actually look like. It actually does a lot of the detail work and also blends all the colors together. At the same time, it also puts a nice protective coat on the outside. Now, for this next step that we're gonna talk about next, you can spray the matte varnish if you want to, if you prefer that look. However, if you do like this very shiny, glossy look, you can skip the next step for the spray varnish, because this is what it's going to look like when you get done washing it. Personally, I don't like the gloss. I like to have them a little bit more matted, so because I am going to move on to the next step for that part. But if you want to keep your miniature looking like that, that is perfectly fine. But as you can see there, this is what it looks like when it's all said and done, and it's a really nice step just to get that done and to move on. So step number 12, like I said before, is a matte varnish spray. I like to use Krylon's matte finish. It's $5 at your local Walmart, and just do a nice little dusting, do the once over with that spray. As you can see, it brings out all the details, so that way you can see like how the oil wash has seeped into the grips. It's darkened the weapons as well, brought up a lot of the detail, and also gives them kind of like this grimy look too. So it looks really, really awesome. Very satisfied with the way that the matte varnish spray is done. So once you get done matte spraying it and finishing it up that way and protecting it, the next thing we need to do now is work on the bases that these miniatures are standing upon. All right, so for that, step number 13 is a base coat. So as you can see here, all I do is I paint their bases with Pavement by Appleboro Paint. It's a 2 fluid ounce tube that runs you 50 cents at your local Walmart. If you're wondering what the texturing is on the miniatures, what I use is a combination of wood glue as well as water and sand. The first thing I do is I base coat the entire base with wood glue. Then I just sprinkle some sand on it. And by sand, I mean sand from outside, not modeling sand. Paying for modeling sand is insane, since the entire planet is pretty much made up of dirt. So, you know, why buy something when it's free? So all I do then is I just dust it with some sand from outside real quick, and then of course let it dry. Then I just put a watered down mixture of water and wood glue over the top of it to seal it all together. And then once of course that's all done, you just paint it with Pavement. I want these ladies to look like they're walking across an ashen blasted wasteland, and I want these miniatures to also blend in with the Iron Golem's warband that we've painted earlier for our Mordheim campaign. And so that's exactly the same kind of basing look I'm going with those guys. So just do two thin layers of Pavement paint, and then you're ready to go on for a dry brush. So we go to step number 14 and 15, and steps 14 and 15 are a dry brush. Step number 14, you do a quick dry brush real quick with Burnt Sienna by Folk Art on top of the black pavement. Burnt Sienna runs you about 65 cents at your local Hobby Lobby, and then of course you do a final dry brush with Granite Gray by Apple Barrel Paint to give this kind of like finished wasteland kind of look to it. So as you can see there in this picture, it kind of gives like this kind of blasted, ashy, you know, dusty wasteland that these ladies are basically walking across. And then once you're done with that dry brushing, you're pretty much done with the base work. All you gotta do now is rim the base and paint. And the color we're gonna use for the rim of the base is once again Burnt Sienna, same color we used earlier to dry brush it. Just do two thin layers of Burnt Sienna along the rim of the base, so that way it just has a nice neutral color for it to blend in, at the same time make it look like they're walking across an ashy battlefield. And once you're done with that, you're pretty much done with these miniatures. And once again, this is what the final result will look like when you're done, which is the photo we showed you earlier in the battlefield. And as you can see here, your Spire Tyrants are completely done. So it doesn't matter which Spire Tyrant you paint, if you, as long as you use this technique to get it done, it's gonna look really awesome. We have a really good tabletop finish, and it's gonna save you a lot of money as well. And at the same time, even though these two ladies are from a different warband, they actually look like they actually blend in with the rest of the Iron Golem's warband because of the red color scheme and everything else, as well as the base job. It does a really nice job of making them look like they're part of that warband and they've always been members of it. which is actually kind of cool. So now that we're done showing you guys how to cheaply as well as quickly paint up the Spire Tyrants, let's go and talk about the money you'll be saving as well. What we're going to do is we're going to run two different lists. The very first list I'm going to show you guys is the recommended paints that Games Workshop as well as Army Painter would suggest that you use to paint these guys up, using Games Workshop Citadel range of paints as well as Army Painter technical stuff materials. We're going to show you how much that's going to cost, and then we're going to show you the method that I use to paint these guys up and show you exactly how much money you're going to save with that. So that being said, let's go and get the shopping list on a roll. So first of all, let's go and talk about the shopping list you need to purchase for Citadel as well as Army Painter in order to paint these guys up using the name brand paints. Now we're doing this in the assumption that you're buying all these materials in order to make this stuff happen. First of all, to do the priming, you'll need to buy a can of Korax White Spray for Games Workshop, would run to $17, as well as a can of Retributor Armor Spray so that way you can get that gold base done. That's going to run you another $28 on top of that. Next, you're going to need Eschen Gray for all the black parts that you're going to paint for the leather. That's going to run you $4.55. And to do the dry brushing all the gray, you'll need by Ulthuan Gray, which runs you $4.55 for that as well. Now for the hair that we did for that orange color for one of the fighters, you'll need to buy Troll Slayer Orange. And then for, of course, all the cording and wrapping that we did in Tahitian Blue, you'll need to buy Baharoth Blue, which also runs you $4.55 for that as well. Now for the gray colors that we use throughout these miniatures, you'll need to buy Anita's Gray, which runs you, Slaanesh Gray, which runs you $4.55 for that. And for the flesh, you'll need to buy Rakarth Flesh, which also runs you $4.55 as well. Now for all the silver pieces that we did, you'll need to buy Lead Vulture, which runs you $7.80 for that. For all the colors that we use Burnt Sienna for, you'll need to buy Doombull Brown, which runs you $4.55. And then for that sandy kind of honey brown colored hair that we did for one of our fighters, you'll need to use Talaran Sand, which runs you $4.55 as well. Now to do the quick paint method, you'll need to buy a can of Army Painter Strong Tone, which runs you $32. And if you wanted to get that flat matte varnish on the miniatures, you'll need to buy Munitorium Varnish, which runs you also $19.50. If you were to buy all these materials on this list in order to paint these miniatures using the Citadel as well as Army paint supplies, that's going to cost you a grand total of $145.25, which is a hell of a lot of cash. So let's go and talk about the cheapskate method that we use, and this is the shopping list that we have. And once again, we are assuming that you're purchasing all these materials for the very first time in order to paint up your miniatures. So first of all, you need to buy a can of Rust-Oleum Flat White Primer, which runs you $3.99 at your local Walmart. Same thing with Krylon Gold Spray Paint with a satin finish that runs you $3.99 as well. From Walmart, you'll also need to buy Apple Barrel's Pavement for all the black, as well as Granite Gray for the dry brushing, and Ripe Tomato as well for the hair. That's going to run you 50 cents per tube. Next, for all the cordings and the wrappings and the grips and stuff, you'll need Delta Serum Coats Tahitian Blue, which runs you 65 cents for that. And then, of course, for all from Anita's acrylic paint, you'll need to buy Gray, True Red, as well as Taupe Gray. Those run just 65 cents a piece. For all the parts that are going to be done in silver, you'll need to buy Folk Arts Gunmetal Gray for 75 cents, as well as for all the dry, the basing work, you'll need to buy a tube of Folk Arts Burnt Sienna, which also runs you 75 cents as well. And if you want to get that kind of honey blonde color look for one of the fighters that we used for her hair, you'll need to buy a tube of Americana Honey Brown, which runs you 65 cents as well. Now to do the quick paint method, you'll need to buy a can of Midwax Poly Shade Mission Oak Color that runs you $6.99, as well as a can of Krylon Matte Varnish Spray, runs you $5.99 to get that matte finished. Now, assuming that you purchase everything on this list for the very first time, we're talking about a grand total investment of $27.21. And when you compare that with $145.25 for Citadel, you end up with a total savings of $118.04, which is about enough for you guys to buy a package of toilet paper or some hand sanitizer in the black market in our current state for our planet. So there you go, ladies and gentlemen. That's going to be exactly how you guys can cheaply and quickly paint up some Spire Tyrants for Warcry and saving you $118 at the same time. So with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, please feel free to like, comment, and or subscribe. Your guys' input is invaluable to us as always. Also check us out on Facebook, Instagram, as well as blogger.com for all the latest greatest hobby news related to our channel. That's good for this one, you guys. We'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace out and stay classy.